Alright, well, we just have the celebs of AVP Seattle signing autographs and taking pictures. We got Rowdy Lennon and John Schwengel playing in their first main draw. And tell our listeners and viewers how you guys earned the berth into the main draw.
Well, basically what happened is we played in an AVP First National Championship last year at the Hermosa AVP. And it was this cool tournament. We got like the final on center court and everything. But at the time we had no idea what we were playing for. So we won that. A couple months later, they invite us out to this kind of like AVP fashion show thing. And we're just sitting there watching, having a good time. And then out of nowhere, Mark Schuermann gets on a mic and says, "This is John Schwengel, Rowdy Lennon. These guys get a wild card spot into an AVP of their choice."
Not bad.
Yeah. Oh my God, that's awesome. Yeah.
Surreal.
We're so psyched.
Very surreal. And so how has the main draw experience been? I know you had the dream draw with Phil Dahlhauser, Nick Lucena at like 11 o'clock this morning.
Yeah.
How was it? On stadium court too.
It was really awesome. You could feel the energy from the crowd, and we had a lot of fans out there, we could tell. Yeah. So it really felt good, and we're playing arguably the best in the world, so not much more you could ask for.
It was such a cool experience too, just like kind of rolling up to the qualifier at 1 o'clock, kind of checking out the games, you know, like it was really kind of relaxing.
Yeah, getting that athlete badge and signing some papers, it's pretty legit.
Contracts,
it's a cool feeling. And now, John, I know that you played 12 sets in the New York qualifier a couple weeks ago, so you know how crazy they are. How nice is it just to be hanging out on a Thursday instead of grinding and grinding and grinding?
Honestly, the qualifiers are kind of more intense than the main draw. Everybody's way more into it. They're playing for whether their trip is paid for or not. They're battling it out really hard against these teams that they're playing over and over and going back and forth with. And it was so nice not having to take part in that.
And now you guys get the Players Hotel, get the athlete tent, you get your athlete badges. So how has the overall experience been? Is it like what you expected the main draw to be, or is it more or less?
No, not at all. It's super relaxed, and that's what's so great about it. Everyone's so like close here, and you can tell that everyone's kind of friends. So it's really just awesome feeling a part of that friend group.
And how different is it, you know, having girls ask for autographs and pictures?
Yeah, seriously, feeling a little famous.
Yeah, it's not bad. Yeah. So what would be next for you guys then? So are you traveling around playing the rest of the AVPs, or are you doing indoor stuff? What's up with you guys?
So I'm gonna try to finish out all the AVP qualifiers and playing that. He's got some other plans. He's gonna try to play the AVPs,
I'm gonna try and do Manhattan and Hermosa, but during San Francisco, I'm going to China for the U19 World Champs. And then come back from that, definitely playing in Hermosa, definitely Manhattan, gonna try Chicago. But yeah, just playing in everything we can, trying to get experience and stuff.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Now, are you going to China with Timmy Brewster?
Yeah, with Timmy.
Okay. So then, who is your ideal partner that you're looking to, or are you a free agent?
I'm a free agent. I'm looking for you to pick up. Yeah. No, I'm a free agent, so I've been having some troubles finding partners, but you know, that happens.
And how'd you guys feel that you played today, just competing-wise? I know that you scored a little bit more against Kame and Timmy Baumgren there. So how'd you guys feel like you competed in the main draw?
I think for me, it was a little bit of nerves and higher expectations for my opponents, you know, like thinking that they were gonna do way more than just play volleyball. Like that's what I needed to keep in my mind is it's volleyball. It's the same thing over and over again. Nothing different, no matter who I'm playing.
How about you? How do you think you went?
Well, I mean, for the most part, these guys, they're, like Rowdy said, they're just volleyball players. And a lot of it is just knowing how to play at the top level. It's not the level, it's the knowledge. Right. And just knowing how to put the ball down, what to do in certain scenarios. And we could really see how they had a lot of that and we didn't have as much, you know?
Uh-huh. Yeah. And now you were coming off of a fairly big experience in Cuba too. Is there a difference in pressure and just the magnitude of the tournament, or is it about the same?
Cuba was Team USA going up against kids our age. We had everything to lose. Very stressful, not good conditions at all. Our hotel was horrible, the venue was horrible, everything was not fun. And that was a pretty stressful trip. This is, we come up here, nothing to lose, playing against the best in the world. nothing to lose. Hotel is awesome. Venue is beautiful. The
venue's unbelievable.
Yeah. Yeah. So very, very different. Each cool in their own way, but very different experiences.
Right. Now, if you guys had to take like some big lessons or takeaways from the experience, what would, you know, the biggest thing you learned, the biggest couple things that you learned, or just like, you know, just memories in general?
I really think that the biggest thing that we can take away is just playing against these players that are at the level we want to be at, and just knowing what we have to do when we go back to California and start training, knowing how high we have to shoot, the angles we have to hit, the angles we have to defend against. So that was a big takeaway, being able to play against them and knowing what we have to do to get better. And then as far as the most memorable experience, for me it would probably be just kind of hanging out with all the players, waiting for the shuttle.
Yep.
That was pretty cool, just having like Ryan Doherty like looking at his watch like, where the hell is the shuttle, you know? that was a good memory.
Yeah. Yeah. Definitely a good takeaway would be mental toughness, you know, staying strong even if the side out's not going your way, because that'll just put you in the tank. And as you can see from the crab game, they were down 14-9 and then the freeze saved them, came back, won the game. That's just mental toughness right there. That needs to be practiced.
All right, boys. We appreciate you coming on SANDCAST. Yeah. Congratulations
you
on your first main draw.
Yeah.
Of course, dude.
Hope to see you guys in it the rest of summer.
Yeah, definitely.
We'll do.
All right, thanks, fellas.
That was fun.